You're back, and all curious about gangs in this world, eh? Well, let's start with an interesting one, the League of Fatties, before we get into gangs like the McDonald Marauders or the Ape Gang. Around 2080, scoffing, which is a sport of speed and volume eating, became popular to bored citizens who took to the idea of the good times decadence, as it promoted joy through eating, and thus gluttony to pass the time in the blocks. In time, it became so popular that scoffing became an Olympic sport, along with other prestigious awards like the Mega City Fats Award. This obviously also made it that many citizens of Mega City 1 started to take it, that the desired body image was that of the gigantically obese. Parents even sent their kids to camps to gain weight, and poor citizens tried to bulk up, hoping to become pro eaters for fame or fortune. And they started to get so heavy that the belly wheel was created, as they needed to prop up their guts so they could be mobile. The people who took part in the sport became respected athletes of the time, and climbing to the top even meant out-eating people in criminal backstreet eating games. Now capitalism is still a thing, and so to differentiate itself, there were even competitions where fatties were eating bedspreads, and thus fatties became a common sight by 2100, as gluttony was one of the few pleasures that was not a crime. And of course, it is then, with an aim for excellence in the sport, that the first one-ton man, Big Lard Ringer, came about and was swiftly arrested after he rode downhill. Now, after the disastrous Apocalypse War 2104, food became a much more limited resource, and thus the fatties were distraught, and the whole society begging and frauding to get food. Norm skinnies or bones, or normal people as the fatties called them, also turned on the fatties, seeing them as a liability in the megacity that had limited food, and yet they were still fat and eating more than their fair share. It got so antagonistic that some even suggested eating the fatties with their large abundance. Thus feeling threatened and hangry from a lack of food, a group of fatties formed the League of Fatties, led by Dick Porker, and started stealing extra food to keep up their lifestyle, as they saw eating as an inalienable right, and to prevent it was a hate crime. Some were so caught up in the new gang that they committed suicide to stop a Texas City food convoy. These food raids saw mass wedges of fatties moving forward, their fat protecting them from anything but the most lethal weapons. And once they built up momentum with their belly wheels, were nigh on unstoppable. When innocent citizens, and more importantly, judges were killed by a fatty stampedes and belly flops protecting a food storage facility, Mega City 1's justice system and Chief Judge Magruder acted and passed a fat control law that stated that all fatties were restricted to just four special blocks like Marlon Brando and Orson Welles' block, and that none of them would be allowed out until they fell below 300 kilograms. Inside, they were, well, according to the fatties, tortured as they had to exercise and keep to a diet. But sometimes, some fatties got out and would then binge on food before returning to the block. As time went on, there were still those who sought out the spot and held illegal eating competitions, smuggling out fatties to participate when they could. In 2107, rationing was declared over, and the fatties were allowed back on the streets, and even eating competitions were legal again. And as usual, humans having short memories, and thus the sport became popular and profitable again. In fact, even the fat camps came back into being, and kids would be appalled to hear how the 21st century camps had expected people to lose weight. So that is the gang that is the League of Fatties. Next time, maybe we can talk about Ronald McDonald and the Burger Wars. Till next word.